from the very beginning of our work together, we're interested in materials. What are the meanings that are connoted by the use of certain materials?
Certain materials talk or speak of their usage and have like a practical function, but there's also this symbolic dimension that a material has.
In the case of chalk, we were just interested in the matter-of-factness of what chalk is. It is at once an ideological tool, something that you find in the classroom.
But it's a geological...
But it's also a geological substance. It's chalk is something that's found naturally in the earth. And because of its nature, it is ephemeral and fragile.
This idea of making these gigantic chalks, you can write big words physically, but perhaps also symbolically.
Our idea was to place the chalk where the governmental buildings of Peru are located. Every day they would allow for protesters to go and make a kind of lap around the plaza, and that's your opportunity to publicly voice whatever demands you might have. The protesters, they realized that this was like another way to vocalize and to make visible their demands. People were writing, "They're for this political party," and then someone would cross it out and write something else.
People writing declarations of love.
And it really became a complex sort of forum that was all being registered on this floor.
It's not like a sculpture that has one end or is only used in one particular way. You have all this multiplicity of positions.
That piece has the potential to actively disrupt what are the norms of a particular setting.
A police squad, they arrested the sculpture. They took all the chalk, they
put
them in a military
wagon.
Truck, yeah. And they took them away.